Clean Cleveland is part of the Healthy Neighborhood Initiative and is made possible by the passage of Issue 32. Each week, the various service departments take a systemic approach to repairing, cleaning, and upgrading the neighborhoods. Look for the Healthy Neighborhood Impact Teams making a difference in your neighborhood.
Hello, welcome to the Clean Cleveland Show. I'm Dan Monroe. Today we're in the Stockyard neighborhood. We're going to catch up with the Healthy Neighborhood Impact Team to see what they're doing in your area. But first, let's learn a little bit about the Stockyard neighborhood.
The neighborhood gets its name from the Cleveland Union Stockyards Company, an early 1900s livestock yard. At its peak, the area was the country's seventh largest meat slaughtering and packing operation. The stockyards eventually closed in 1968. Starting in 1892, the Pilsener Brewing Company produced almost 400,000 barrels of beer a year in the neighborhood. The brewery was eventually sold to C. Schmidt & Sons, which brewed its last beer in 1984.
Joining me now is Rich Silva, Commissioner for Parks and Maintenance. Commissioner, talk about your crew's role in the Clean Cleveland Initiative.
Division of Park Maintenance role in Clean Cleveland is to remove illegal dumping throughout the city. We work in tandem with the other divisions. We identify illegal dumping in the area, whether it be dumping on a vacant lot or a vacant structure. And then we use tandem dump trucks, small front end loader, and a hand crew to remove that illegal dumping citywide. And we will probably remove about 1,000 locations during the 2017 this year.
Well, talk about what's happening behind us, Commissioner.
So behind us, there's a crew working on a vacant structure, some illegal dumping in a vacant structure. They get, as you can see, they've got the small loader, the large tandem dump trucks. Once they load these trucks, they'll go to the dump. And we have three dump trucks so that the loader can continue to work seamlessly.
Commissioner, how do you identify locations of where you need to work at?
We actually send inspectors out ahead of time, and we inspect every vacant structure and vacant lot throughout the city, identify the dumping, what type of resources are needed to remove it, and then schedule it.
Now, obviously, you don't have a lot of eyes throughout the city, but you do have residents. How can residents help in identifying places of illegal dumping?
So if a resident actually sees illegal dumping going on, can it help in identifying who's doing it? They should call 911. It is considered a 911 call, and the Cleveland police will investigate it and try to hold the responsible party accountable. If it's something that's already been dumped, there's no information leading to the dumper, and it just needs to be cleaned up, they should call 420-8300, which is the city's call center, and they will give them a reference number, and we will get it on the location schedule and service it accordingly.
Now let's take a look at what the Division of Parks and Maintenance has been working on. Thanks to the hard work of the Healthy Neighborhood Impact Team, tons of illegally dumped garbage has been removed from your streets. That is the Clean Cleveland Initiative in action. Now, let's go take a look at some Cleveland trivia.
Standing 708 feet tall, the Terminal Tower was the second tallest building in the world upon its completion in 1930.
Well, that's it for this episode of Clean Cleveland. Be sure to look for the Healthy Neighborhood Impact Team in your community. Thanks for watching. For TV20, I'm Dan Monroe.